bum, 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 make the roaches red. Make the roaches red. We dare to stop a wasted bum, so let the beauty be spread. Make the roses red. Make the roses red. Oh, 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 oh. Make the roses red. And then a tear we shed.
Because we know it seems to grow.
In fact, they'll soon be dead.
Thank you. very curious.
Twinkle, twinkle, little bat, how I wonder where you're at. You know the song, perhaps?
I've heard something like it.
It goes on, like this. Up above the world you fly, like a tea tray in the sky, twinkle, twinkle,
twinkle, twinkle, twinkle, twinkle, twinkle, twinkle.
And I had just finished the first verse. When the queen bawled out, off with his head, he's murdering time.
How dreadfully savage.
And ever since then, it's always been sick.
Is that the reason so many tea things are put out here?
Yes, exactly so. And we have no time to wash the teacups in between waters.
Then you keep moving around, I suppose.
Of course, it's the things that you stole.
But when you come to the beginning again?
Suppose you change the subject. I'm getting tired of this. I hope that Naomi tells a story.
I'm afraid I don't know one.
Wake up, Dormouse.
I wasn't going to say, I heard everything you fellows were saying.
Tell us a story.
Yes, please do.
And do it quickly or else you'll fall asleep again.
Once upon a time, there were three little sisters. They lived at the bottom of the world. They were called Elsie, Lily, and Tilly. And they lived at the bottom of the world.
What did they live on?
They lived on treacle.
They couldn't have done that, you know. They'd have been ill.
So they were. Very ill.
But why did they live at the bottom of a well?
Take some more tea.
I've had nothing yet, so I can't take more.
You mean you can't take less? It's very easy to take more than nothing, you know.
Nobody asked your opinion.
Oh, who's making the personal remarks now?
Why did they live at the bottom of a well?
It was a treacle well.
There's no such thing in this world.
If you can't be civil, you tell the story yourself.
No, please go on. I won't interrupt again. I dare say, there may be one.
One indeed. And so, they were learning to draw, you know.
What did they draw? Treacle.
I want a clean cup. I suggest we all move down one place. Clean
cup,
clean cup, move down, move down,
clean cup,
move down.
And I don't quite understand you. Where did they draw the treacle from?
You can draw water from a water well, so I'm sure you can draw treacle from a treacle well.
Stupid!
But they were in the well!
They were, of course they were. Well in. They were learning to draw, you know. All manner of things. Things that begin with an M.
Why with an M?
Why not?
Things that begin with an M. Such as mouse traps, the moon, and memory, and muchness. You know they say things are much of a muchness. Have you ever seen a drawing of a muchness?
Now you ask me, I don't
Then you
think.
Shouldn't speak.
That's it, I'm getting out of here. This is the stupidest tea party I ever was at in all my life.
Such great children to work with. So can we have a round of applause for the children and the grown-ups? But somebody did say to me that somebody else had something to do with our production this evening, and I think somebody somewhere out there in the outer darkness might have something. So if you want to come forward, those people. We've got here, my wife's on her way. Oh my goodness. Sorry, can I just apologise for being out here? Is that okay? Am I an idiot?
We will do it about this. Miss Urinda?
So where's Miss Urinda?
Where's
that? Oh, so we've got here Miss Urinda. the makeup, the costumes, all the artwork and everything else, that was Miss Yorinda, and she did a fantastic job. Miss Yorinda, please. And then, of course, the directrice of our play and the major force behind it, the force, what's the phrase? Force majeure? Is that the correct phrase? Does anybody speak French? Clearly I don't. So what is it? Force majeure. Thank you. The force majeure behind the play is Miss Chris. Thank you. And then we've got some more, which are they presumably for Miss Chris and Miss Yorinda as well. And are they from the parents? They are. So from the parents, you've got some flowers as well. So thank you all so much. It's lovely.
Helps the students as well with their music and with choreography. Where are you?
She's not here.
Yes,
she,
I can
she
see
is,
some
are you
hands
here?
Over there.
Come out here. What are you doing there? Miss Renaud, where are you? I'm practicing. Do you like my French accent? Is it any good? Come on. Sorry? She said to me, I don't speak French, as if I do. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, please. Miss Caroline, thank you. We'll do a little bit of a presentation there, so we've got a photo moment. Right, is there anybody else out there that's got any flowers? Are we finished? Are we done? Does anybody in the audience like any flowers? Sorry?
Oh, sweet.
Oh, we've got some more flowers. A round of applause over there for a flower.
So, thank you very much. We will try to keep on putting more productions, more shows, more everything in which you guys will also be involved because you help the students prepare themselves and you, as Chris said, you give us the talent. So, thank you.
Are you
going to
scare
us by showing us
the audience?
No. So now, outside, we have a cupcake tea party, very into a mad tea party motif. So please go enjoy cupcakes, enjoy some tea. Normally we would do it with cheese and wine, but cupcakes and tea will be enough.